Hello guys, it's Eglow here. You're welcome to my YouTube channel. You're welcome to this tutorial as well. In this video, right, so I'll be showing you how, you know, I move from this to this. You understand, you know, how I was able to find my way around this background, come up with this amazing result. You know, this is how I shot the picture. You understand, this is how I shot the picture. You can see from the picture that, you know, even from the shoot, I already created them three-dimensional. You understand? Now you can see highlight, you can see shadow, and you can see mix tune. So we're heading straight to the Photoshop now, where we're going to do the magic, right? First thing to do first is I'll have to resize this picture to Instagram size as 4x5, right? But then I'll have to get rid of this you know, wanted place, this iron, get rid of this iron. Then, and also, I'm gonna use my lasso to select this, then right click and fill, choose content aware. All right, good. Now you can see, so deselect. Deselect. All right, now you can see. So let's go to crop. Yeah, so some content aware already, so I'll just mark for it to fill. So now if you look at the background, now let me zoom in a little bit. If you look at the background now, you can see that the background is not smooth. You understand, you can see that the background is not smooth. Now we need to smoothen the background a little bit, and then at the same time make sure that we have it, you know, plain. You understand, because of course I use plain white paper backdrop for the shoot, and I want, that's the result I want to have. So I don't want, you know, to have another color. I don't want it to turn to gray. I don't want to turn to something else, right? So what I will do now is I'll select the subject. Yeah, you can come here, select the subject. Yeah, I'll select even the chair. So select everything, right? Because my concern is just the background, nothing more. So I pay attention to details very, very well. Now I have to feather it first, you understand? So feather it to like let's say one, then enter key, right? So after feathering, right, so we're going to create layer in command J. Yeah, this is it. Now you can see there's a need for you to separate both the subject and the background for you to be able to work on, you know, background separately, right? So now I'm going to pick my brush and then, you know, hold Alt from the keyboard and pick this area, then go to solid color. You go to solid color, you're going to have something like this, you understand? Then now the background has, that selection we did has picked this for us, so you just okay it. Now reduce the opacity to like 40. You know, this is before, this is after, this is before, this is after. I'm going to make this layer together. Fix my missile brush. Then create a layer. So I'm just, you know, smoothing this area. Or just smoothing it. This is before, this is after. We are done with the background. Now after this, now we're going to make the layer. Right, you can select, then you know, command E from the keyboard to make the layer, right? So now the next step is to select the subject again. The reason is what we want to do is strictly for background. We need to separate the subject from the background for us to be able to achieve our desired result or what we wanted. Now we're going to select the subject again, just like we did before, right? Select the subject again. I'll feather it again like you, just one. Yeah, good. So after feathering it, then you click on the background. So the prop that I'll be using for this manipulation, I got it from Pinterest. You can see now. So I got it from Pinterest. So I already, you know, have it saved on my download now, you know, bringing it to the picture. So make sure you fill it. Make sure you expand it till everything fills to, you know, the whole space of the size of the picture. Then I make sure you resize it, centralize it. Do you understand? Because, you know, we need to keep it real. The shadows and everything needs to be perfect, like everything needs to fit in.
So make sure you position it very well till you are satisfied, right?
Yeah, this is fine now. Good. This is fine. So I still need to, I'm still reduce it a little bit. Okay. Yeah, good. Now I've infused the props, right, that beautify the background, but it's not perfect because it's looking like the subject is floating and we don't want it that way. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to come to my layer mask. I'm going to mask it. Now click on the mask layer and hide it, right? So from the keyboard you're going to command I to hide it. This is command I to hide it. Now I'm going to pick my brush, to be around let's say the opacity let's say around 70. The flow as your foreground is going to be on white. You know, white is to reveal, white black is to hide. Please take note. So now I'm going to, you know, start revealing the prompts. Right now, if you look at this place now, I don't want to kill this shadow here. I don't want to kill this shadow. I'm going to reduce my opacity to like 20. Yeah, to like 20. Yeah, nine. Okay, so 19 now. That's fine. Then flow as well to around that figure. Around, okay, flow is on 21 now. So reduce my my brush and just, you know, blend it. You understand? Just blend it. This is before, this is after. Guys, you can see. This looks so real and mature. It's something simple, right? But it's classic. You understand? So let me show you where we moved from. You know, we moved from here. You know, you go to history, move from here. You can see, wow. Move from here to here. This is massive, guys. So this is it, guys. This is how I transform this picture from here to here. You can see the before and after now. So guys, I think we can you know, make the layers now and you know, save the pictures. Come to the end of the class. So guys, if you are a returning subscriber, don't forget to like, share and comment as well. And if you're just coming into the channel as, you know, first time, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like, comment and share as well, so that others can see this this work. Thank you, bye.